RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to be going over acid-base neutralization reactions. And so the first thing, just to get our definitions down, when we're talking about acid-base neutralization reactions, that almost always means eventually somehow reacting H plus with OH minus to form water. So that's what you want to be on the lookout for, is that we're going to have these reactions and that this is going to be one of the things that happens in this reaction. And so the first thing we've got to know about this reaction is, how does it fall apart? We've got two molecules, but we're basically going to be separating it into ions. And so we've got to know, what are those ions going to be? And so you're going to base your knowledge based off of two things mostly. One, your general knowledge of the periodic table and how things break down and what their charges are. And two, from a common ion list that you're either given or you're asked to memorize. So breaking everything into its components, HBr is going to be broken down into positively charged H and negatively charged bromine. This is just based off of valence electrons from the periodic table. And now sodium hydroxide is going to break down into Na plus and OH minus. We know that sodium is going to be 1 plus from the periodic table, and we know that OH or hydroxide is going to be 1 minus from that common ion list. So now we're going to recombine our components to see what our products are, and there's a couple of different things you can use to figure out what those new molecules are going to be. One is to know that opposite charges attract, so we're only going to make new molecules if we have a positive thing and a negative thing. We're never going to combine two positive things or two negative things. And the way to kind of memorize that is that inside goes with inside and outside goes with outside. All right, so now filling out our top reaction based off of our opposite charges and our inside, inside, outside, outside rule, let's go ahead and see what we're going to form. So first, our two outsides, H plus and OH minus, this is going to do the reaction I was talking about at the very beginning. This is how we form water. This is how we make H2O. And now looking at what's left, we're going to make sodium bromide. All right, so this whole thing, this is all my molecular equation. And so now let's finish our next equation, which is also going to be our total ionic equation. So first, let's fill in the products. Well, first, we know that H plus and OH minus combines to form H2O. And this might be a little bit tricky to think about at first, but this is now no longer two different ions, right? This is now a new covalent molecule. So we're not going to draw it as two separate things. This is kind of the whole point of this reaction. The neutralization in this case is saying that we had an acidic ion, H+, we had a basic ion, OH-, and now when they combine, they don't have any ionic charges. It's just a neutral molecule of H2O. And now to see what's going to happen with sodium and bromine, we've got to check out our solubility charts. So looking up sodium, we can see that that is going to be a soluble ion, and it doesn't actually have any exceptions. So we're definitely going to have sodium bromide be soluble. We can also double check this by looking up bromide and seeing that that's also soluble, and its only exceptions don't include sodium. So what that means for our total ionic equation is that we're still going to write it like this, because what the total ionic equation expresses is, what does this actually look like when it's dissolved in water? So when it's actually dissolved, you aren't going to have HBr molecules actually interacting with each other. They immediately dissociate and they become H plus and Br. And so even though we say, oh yeah, we're going to make sodium bromide up at our molecular equation, when it's dissolved in water, it still just is Na plus and Br minus. So drawing your equation either one of these ways is correct, but one is just showing you the molecules and we're not caring about the fact that it's dissolved in water, and one is showing you what the molecules actually are when this is in water. This is also kind of a good point to remember that all of these things are happening in water anyway, and we're actually just creating another extra water molecule. All right, so now that we have these, let's just go ahead and dot our I's and cross our T's and make sure that they're super correctly formatted. So one is just balancing. So going through and looking, these actually are completely balanced, just because this happens to be an equation where everything is balanced automatically. We don't have to add any numbers. So that's great. And the other thing we have to add is whether these things are aqueous, which means dissolved, or if they are a gas, solid, or liquid. So because HBr is soluble, we're going to write that as aqueous. NaOH, also soluble, and we can check that by looking at OH minus is usually insoluble, but it has an exception with Na. This will also be aqueous. And now H2O, this one's a little bit tricky. This is, even though it is in water, this is going to be a liquid because this is not ionic, it's not breaking apart, it's just a molecule that is in liquid state. And then NaBr, because that's soluble, this will still be aqueous. All right, so now let's go ahead and add that in for the total ionic equation, and it's the exact same as the molecular equation. All right, and now that we have these, let's go ahead and do our third equation, the net ionic equation. And so this one I like doing because it's essentially just the total ionic equation, but we get to cross stuff off. So taking this guy, pulling it down here, and now we just cancel out anything that's on both sides. That includes Br and Na. And we call these spectator ions because they don't do anything. They just spectate the other reaction happening around them. And so we know they don't do anything because they're the exact same on both sides. And now this actually is our net ionic equation, but I'm going to go ahead and redraw so it's a little bit nicer. All right, so these are our three reactions. And remember that for acid-base neutralization reactions, you're pretty much going to have this as your net ionic equation every time. That's kind of the whole point, is that we had something that reacted that made us have H plus plus OH minus, and we made water. All right, good luck and happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks. That's it. Happy studying.